Good evening, everyone. I hope you all are safe in this drastic pandemic of COVID-19. I, Rahul Jain, member of Sikasa Indore branch of CIRC of ICAI, welcome you all to the third day of webinar for CA students. As you know, we have already conducted two sessions of webinar on GST and practical approach for audit. We now present to you our third webinar on office etiquettes and behavioral aspects. We all know that office etiquettes and manners are very important in this corporate world. From this session, we will learn the objective of training and disciplined attitude. We have in mind many questions. Why developing ethical values is important, or what should you keep in mind before reporting your work to your boss? Why subject knowledge, research, and teamwork are very important? And to get answers to all of these questions, we have today with us a very experienced personality in the CA profession, CA Manoj Fadnis sir. I welcome you, sir. We are very pleased to have you here. Sir, let me talk about sir now. CA Manoj Fadnis sir is a renowned speaker not only all over India but overseas also. Sir has served the ICAI office as a president and chairman to all the other standing committees. He is also the member of the group constituted by the Accounting Standard Board of the ICAI. Sir has played a major role in creation and convergence of the Indian accounting standards. He has also been elected as the president of Confederation of Asian and Pacific Accounting Board. So we have here, sir, I hope you all will implement the knowledge you gain from sir today and implement in your life. Sir, I now request you to take this presentation forward. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Rahul. Honorable Chairman of Indore Branch, CA Harsh Firoda, Chairman of CA Students Association, and a very dear friend, CA Samkit Bhandari. In fact, my topic today on office etiquettes is a topic which I thought Samkitji should have taken. He is a very good motivator speaker and very good in so many matters. But I'm still thankful to Samkitji for giving this wonderful opportunity of meeting so many CA friends, CA students across the city of Indore, and as I'm told, in different parts of the country. This program, my fellow co-speaker, CA Ayushvi, who will be taking some of the topics today with me. Very nice to share this video meeting with a young chartered accountant and a very talented chartered accountant like Ayushvi. The moderator of this session, Rahul, who has done an excellent job in terms of coordinating and bringing all the speakers together and organizing these video shows, and my dear student friends. So this COVID-19 has given us ample opportunities, different types of opportunities, though we cannot meet physically, but we are meeting in a virtual world. The advantage of virtual world is certainly there. Till 4 hours, 59 minutes, we were occupied with different work, and 5 o'clock, all of us are connected in this virtual world. And 6 o'clock or 6:15, when this program ends, we are all back to the other activities with which we are occupied. So COVID-19 is changing the way the business is taking place. COVID-19 is going to change a lot of business activities, business models. And COVID-19 is also going to change a lot of professional methodologies, professional activities, the way we are carrying out our professional work. But I can assure you what will not change is the basic office etiquettes. So it is good to be discussing this topic in this session. I have a small presentation. I'll take you through that presentation, which is originally prepared by Board of Studies in terms of the general management and communication skills program which the institute organizes. So I hope this presentation is visible to you. And as technology always plays some funny games, a little bit of problem for me in starting this slideshow. I wish my other friends were around me in the physical world and who would have helped me in starting this without difficulties, but I'll have to struggle on my own and try and do it. So as it comes up, maybe it will come up shortly. Let me see how it is happening. And it would come up before you. But as we go along, let me start with this. What I'm planning to be sharing with you is certain very basic aspects about our office etiquettes and behavioral aspects. So what is it that we have today? There are some topics which are very common to both Ayushmi and myself, but we have a different thought process on the same subject. So I'm sure you'll find some of the things which we are going to be discussing to be common, but yet there would be a different perspective. So I would be touching upon three aspects in next half an hour or so. Attire and grooming is the first topic, which of course to a large extent Ayushmi would take up, so I'll just rush through this part. I would be focusing more on the meeting etiquettes and the practical aspects of attending the CA office, some of the aspects which Rahul also touched up in the opening remarks. So friends, professional attire and grooming is very important to each one of us. If you see, this is one of the very old but still a very valid proposition that good manners cost nothing, but bad manners can cost you your reputation. So it's very important that we keep our cool, we keep our professional approach, keep the professional dignity of being a chartered accountant student, being a chartered accountant of tomorrow. So while I said the world is changing around us, while it is true that the business models and professional etiquettes would be changing, while the professional methodologies would be changing, but this is important in terms of what is possibly not going to change. So we need to be professional. We need to ensure that we give due respect to others. We respect our parents. We respect our teachers. The principal in your office is your teacher, your guru. The entire articleship fabric is based on this guru-shishya relationship. And the principal is today your guru. You are the shishya. In future, you will be a chartered accountant. You will be the guru and you will have a shishya. So it is this guru-shishya relationship which is core to the chartered accountancy profession. And you must always ensure to respect your principal as a guru who is going to guide you today and who is going to guide you in all your future endeavors. Friends, we as Indians, more particularly it is true and it is said about Indians that we are very judgmental. In a very short time, sooner we meet a person, we make up our mind about so many things about that person. So the first impression is the last impression, as it is said. Your first impression should always be a very good impression. While you meet a person, you talk to a person, quickly you're making a judgment. You're judging that person with respect to his knowledge or her knowledge, with respect to the kind of educational levels, the social levels, so many things we immediately judge about a person in front of us. And in matter of minutes, we decide whether we can trust that person or we can have a long-term understanding or a long-term professional relationship with that person. So being judgmental as we are, as the Indian psychology is there, it is true for people across the world, but more so for people from our country that we are judgmental. So make sure that your first impression is a very good impression because it is going to have a lot of implications insofar as our future is concerned. When you meet a person for the first time, there are so many basic things which we are learning right from our childhood days. And in fact, this COVID-19 has reiterated all those good habits which we learned in our childhood, but somewhere we started neglecting those habits. So the personal hygiene, which is being talked about today, which is very important to each one of us, is something which we have been brought up as all across our life. This is what has been told to us. And this is what is important even from a professional point of view. How you appear, whether you are properly dressed, and so many things which are so fundamental to our appearance. I did not really repeat all these things, but mind you, do remember, these are very important from our day-to-day life. Now, what kind of a dress we should, what dress should we be wearing when we are meeting people professionally? A young chartered accountant like Ayushmi would be better equipped to tell you what is the current trends and how people should be dressed up. I would not take much of your time. This is one part of my presentation, which I would leave it to her to take up. But more of a traditional point of view, more of a professional point of view, what is important for people from our kind of professional background is we should be soberly dressed. We should be professionally dressed. For gents, for males, it is said that a light colored shirt or a white shirt with a dark trouser is what is an ideal dress combination. Of course, in summers, we are not expected to be wearing a tie or a coat unless it's a very, very formal meeting. But otherwise, a light colored shirt and a dark trouser is good enough. Please don't wear jeans or chappals or sandals. It creates a bad impression in the professional atmosphere. So there are a lot of websites, and Ayushmi would take you through that. These are something for the ladies, for the girls. You can be dressed in a traditional sari to something which is more Western oriented. It's up to you, but it should be a professional dress. And in a professional dress, you should not be wearing a lot of heavy jewelries, and your sandals and slippers are also equally important. So keep in touch about these things. This is what you should be doing and what you should not be doing. I hope you agree with me, and I hope Ayushmi also agrees with me, but she will take you through these matters. So these are certain slides about how dressing is important depending on the occasion with which you are connected with. And it is really based on the kind of a program or kind of a occasion for which you are attending. So if it is office, it is different. If you are attending a CS student seminar, it is different. And at the end of the day, when there is a cultural program, you cannot be dressed the way you are dressed in the morning. So depending on the occasions, these are the things which are to be kept in mind. And I'm sure for today's seminar, you are all well dressed up. In fact, it is giving an opportunity to be properly dressed up even though you are at home. I'm sure you are taking good advantage of this occasion. I read a very interesting WhatsApp message a couple of days back that jab wo nagar nigam ki gaadi bhi aati hai to log baag acche se kapde pehen ke bahar jaate hain kyunki that is the only occasion when people get an opportunity to step out. So be that as may, your professional attire is very important. Please keep that in mind. So let me come to a more important topic, which I would be dealing with, is the meeting etiquettes. So friends, you will be attending various business meetings, professional meetings, your office meetings, meetings with clients at different times and different places. Be very sure that you are punctual. Punctuality is very important. If you are late even by a minute, you are late. So if there is a meeting fixed up, try and reach that place, try and enter that meeting room at least 10 minutes before the start of the meeting. This is what is the globally accepted way, that if the meeting is starting at 9 o'clock, you be sure that you are there by 8:50. I have been at the privilege of attending so many meetings across the world. Generally, I found in the international meetings, they start either at 8 o'clock or latest by 8:30. And even if it is at 8 o'clock, people would ensure that they are in the meeting room at 7:45, even if it is dark outside. So meetings, the first and foremost thing is be punctual. Attend the meeting at the right time. Second, when you are attending a meeting, you should know what is the agenda for the meeting. You should be well prepared for the meeting. If you are attending an audit committee meeting, you are attending a meeting with your boss for a client, your client is coming to your office, or you are attending an audit meeting at the client's office, wherever the meeting is, you should be prepared with your role, with the contents of that meeting. What is the purpose of the meeting? What is the agenda for the meeting? You should be well prepared. Assuming it is an audit finalization, you have been involved in carrying out the audit, you should be ready with all your audit working papers. You should have read those papers again. Doesn't matter if you have been doing that audit for last, say, 4 weeks or 6 weeks. Even then, on the last date, at the time of the meeting, you should be well prepared and be ready so that during the course of the meeting, if your boss wants any particular paper or wants to refer to any particular aspect, you should be in a position to provide that information or that page to your boss. So the contents and the agenda of the meeting should be well known to you, and you should be well prepared when you are attending a meeting. Third aspect is, many a times, many of us, and it would have happened even with me at several occasions, we are quite silent in the meeting. I don't mean to say that we should jump up and keep making our points time and again, or I don't mean to say that we should be speaking out of turn, but make sure that you are so well prepared that you can make relevant contribution at a relevant point of time. Friends, you are chartered accountant students, and it's not a rule based in which you can say what is the relevant time and what is the relevant statement. This is where what we say in audit is your professional judgment, professional skepticism. So when you're prepared with the subject matter, you would automatically, and with some experience, come to know what you are expected to say and what at what point in time you should be speaking. So your contribution is important. Don't speak out of turn, but be prepared to speak when you are asked to be spoken, or you feel that you can make a relevant contribution to the discussion which is going on. And by doing that, you will find that your importance in the meetings will get enhanced. So punctuality is important, knowledge content is important, and your alertness is important to know at what point of time what you should be speaking. Then there are so many other etiquettes in the meetings. Greetings is an important part, showing respects to others. And when you meet a person, how you present your business cards is also important. And I'll show you some slides as to how you should be presenting your cards. In fact, when you meet a person, even your handshake is important. Of course, today in COVID-19, this namaste has become more popular globally. Instead of shaking hands, people are saying namaste. And in a way, it is good that something Indian is now being exported worldwide and people are shifting to namaste. So even if you're doing a namaste, your hands should be straight. It should not be like this. It should not be like this. You are not bowing. You are not touching. You be professional. Stand straight and have your hands folded properly. And if you're shaking hands, your handshake should be firm, and it should be a warm and firm handshake. There are various websites which would tell you as to what kind of a handshake is there. If you're shaking hands with a lady, you should not be crushing the hands of that lady. And there are proper etiquettes to be kept in mind in these matters. So go to any of these websites and you will see how important a handshake activity also is. Now coming back to this business cards, if you see the way this person is holding this card and presenting this card, it conveys a meaning. It shows this person is giving proper respect to the person to whom that card is being given. That is important. It is a professional way of introducing yourself. You are giving your business card to us, to another person, in a proper, dignified manner. So keep this in mind and see that you present your card in a professional manner, not just taking out cards from your pocket and generally distributing it as if it is some election meeting or it is some casual meeting. In a professional meeting, make sure you hold your visiting card properly and you present it. Now, how your visiting card should be is also important. So shortly when you become chartered accountants and you would have your business card, make sure that your business card, one, it is in accordance with the requirements prescribed by Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. So there are certain do's and don'ts. A CA emblem is permitted. This emblem with CA, which denotes a chartered accountant, is permitted. And you can have a professional card. It could be in black and white, it could be colored, but it should be a dignified card, so to say. Now, these are cards which you will see on your screen, which are maybe good for somebody who is in business, who is somebody who is in advertisements or in travel industries. You might see people having such kinds of cards, but not for chartered accountants and certainly not for young budding chartered accountants like you. Your cards would be more like this, which are professional cards and give a professional, dignified appearance and speak about you and your personality. Now, friends, the core part of your training is the practical training. As I said earlier, this guru-shishya relationship, which is something very old and sacred in our country. Today, of course, many of you would be watching Ramayana and Mahabharata, which is being telecasted again on Doordarshan, and which is talking about so many things from our history, which are very core and important to our entire Indian culture, so to say. Now, chartered accountants training is the basic fabric around which your entire course curriculum is tailored around. You should consider this as a very good opportunity that you are not just reading what audit is, you are not just reading what income tax law is, you are not just reading what is a Companies Act and what is Schedule 3 and what is the format of the balance sheets and statement of profit and loss. You get an opportunity to walk into an office of a chartered accountant and do it practically, learn it practically. And when you're in a chartered accountant's office for 3 years, and each one of us undergoes that training, even I have done my 3 years training as you are doing today, and as all of us have done, as Samkit has done, as Ayushmi has done, each one of us has to undergo this 3 years training. So this 3 years training in a chartered accountant's office, you get to learn the basic aspects about our professional practice. And when you are learning that, there are so many things which are so important, which you should keep in mind. When I started my professional practice, and that was way back in 1987, 33 years ago, when none of you were, I'm sure, born. In those days, a telephone was a luxury. We used to go to a radio station, the central telegram office, from where we could make a STD call. Or we would book a telephone call or a lightning call, and those were the days when telephones were not available. And as against that, we are so happy and proud to see that every individual, every Indian has a phone in his hand. Now, a telephone, a cell phone, is so very important to our lives that the moment we get up in the morning, right till the time we go to sleep, we have this cell phone in our hands. And it could be a very advantageous thing, and it could be a very disadvantageous matter too. When you are in your office, when you are working in a chartered accountant's office, when you attend any income tax proceedings, when you visit a client, make sure your phone is on a silent mode or it is on a vibration mode, so that if you get a call in between, your call should not disturb others who are working, should not disturb the legal proceedings which are in place, should not disturb the conversation which your principal may be having with his client at that point of time. This is very important. You should not be speaking in public places at a very loud voice. If you are in a public place and you are talking over your phone, make sure that you are speaking in a slow, in a low, moderated tone, so that what you are speaking, only the person to whom you are speaking to can hear, and not people around you in that room or hall, wherever you are. So telephone etiquettes are very important. Second aspect, which I think is important, is when we are working in offices and we are working at places, there are different people working on their laptops, desktops, or iPads and doing different things. Make sure that you don't peep in into your colleague's screen and see what that person is doing or what that person is reading or what that person is working upon. It's a very bad habit. If you're sitting in a public place and there are people around you, you should try and see that whatever you are doing is not visible to others, and at the same time, whatever whoever is sitting next to you, you also don't encroach into the privacy of the other person. These are certain basic fundamental things which you should keep in mind. When you're visiting a client's office, you are representing your boss, you are representing your office, you are representing your firm in that client's place. So your approach should be, you should bear in mind that you are carrying the entire reputation of your office, reputation of your firm, when you are visiting the client's office and dealing with the client or the client's staff. So your approach has to be very positive, very professional, and you should not be giving unnecessary advice to your clients or client staff. Ki sahab itna tax bhar dijiye, itna tax mat bhariye, ye provisions hai. Be very professional in your approach. Be firm, be professional. If you want to share something, do share. But whatever you are sharing, please make sure that you keep your boss informed, take him into confidence, and then you share those information with the client or client's staff. So some of these tips which are important, please keep them in mind. Have a disciplined attitude. Have a questioning attitude. It is good to ask questions. You should not be keeping just silent in a meeting. If you have doubts, you must ask your doubts. It is not wrong to have doubts. Nobody has complete knowledge. Everyone is at different levels of knowledge curve. So on some matters, you would be having more knowledge than me. So many things with respect to technology, I'm sure you know more than what I know. And those things, I would be very happy to learn from you. Similarly, there could be so many things which your seniors know or some of your juniors know. Try and learn from them. And knowledge is something which you should be thirsty for. You should learn anything. Anyone who is willing to teach you, you should be willing to learn that. Never feel shy of asking questions and gaining knowledge. In an office, whether you are 2 articles or you're 20 articles or you're more than those, make sure that you have this capabilities of working in a team. Working in a team is such that you would be able to share certain good things, you would be able to learn certain good things from others, and with the help of each other, you are achieving the common targets and common goals. So that teamwork is very important to be successful in life. Another aspect is confidentiality. See, you are working in an office, you're looking into the income tax matters of the clients, and so many information which you may come across. so many confidential information about your client you would come across, you will come to know. Keep that confidential. You should talk only on need to know basis. You should share that information only if it is required to be shared. Otherwise, you, as a general rule, whatever confidential information you have acquired, you should not share that with anyone and keep complete confidentiality, keep complete trust and confidence with respect to what work you have done. And friends, one of the most important things which I would like to tell you is ethics. You are today in an age group of early 20s. You have more than 4 to 5 decades of professional career ahead of you. Now, if you want to succeed in your life on a long-term basis, on a sustainable basis, on a continuous basis, you must be good in your professional work. But more than that, you must ensure to follow all ethical principles. Ethics is not just a subject or part of a subject which you study for your intermediate or final exams. Ethics is a way of life. And ethics divides persons who are successful and those who are successful once or twice, and those who are successful on a continuous, regular basis, as I said, for your next 5 to 6 decades of your professional career. So ethics is important. Ethics is above the law. Certain things may be legally permissible, but still they may not be ethically correct. So while we are legally compliant, we must ensure that we are ethically correct and keep that as a motto in your life. I've already touched upon certain telephone etiquettes, your phone call etiquettes. Keep those things in mind. And I'm sure you would always be doing these things, but it's important to keep them in mind. Again, with respect to emails, I think Ayushmi can discuss this with you, and she will have some more thoughts on these matters. Surely those would be important, and keep them in mind. So as I conclude my presentation, I wish you a very happy professional career. I wish that till 3rd of May, and more particularly those of my friends who are in Indore, we are living in a red zone district, as it is classified by Home Ministry, Government of India. Stay home, stay safe, and I wish you a very bright professional career. With that, I would hand back to Rahul, and after that, Ayushmi would be making her presentation. Thank you very much. Some of your queries which I saw, which I could not address, I would do them separately. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for the wonderful presentation. One thing that clicked me was that good manners cost nothing, but bad manners cost you your reputation. I think just not reputation, but it costs you everything. So it is very important to understand that respecting our elders, teachers, seniors, juniors, or any person is very important. We need to stop judging others. It is very important to respect everyone so that you can earn their respect too. Also, you said about the office etiquettes. You must be punctual. You should reach the office by before 10 minutes or 15 minutes. Sir, it was a great presentation for all of us. We learned so many things. And I want to add something. You quoted Ramayana for the Guru-Shishya relationship. I think we all must cherish the Guru-Shishya relationship. And I am so glad to have you as my Guru. Thank you very much, sir. And now we will have the second session with CA Ayushmi Khasgiwala, ma'am. Thank you. Hello.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Now for the second session of this webinar, we have with us once again a great personality, CA Ayushmi Khasgiwala, ma'am. I welcome you, ma'am. Let's talk about CA Ayushmi Khasgiwala, ma'am, first. Having qualified as a chartered accountant, she worked in a multinational consultancy firm, KPMG Mumbai, in risk advisory department. Ma'am also holds experience in the field of Indian accounting standards, audit and control, and taxation. She is currently working in association with Ashok Khasgiwala and Company, dealing in mentoring clients to formulate internal control and standard operating procedures. He has conducted various trainings such as business and strategic management at various forums like IMA and DCBS. He was also selected among the only few Indians for Russian Educational Youth Forum, Terra Scientia, by the Ministry of Education and Science of the Russian Federation. It is a great pleasure and honor for us, ma'am, to have you here for the webinar. Now, I request you, ma'am, to take over the webinar to proceed further. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Rahul. I would like to thank ICI Indore branch for organizing such creative events so that in this lockdown period also students and we can utilize our time to the fullest with proper learnings and proper knowledge. Thank you so much. And it is my privilege, Manoj sir, that I'm sharing this topic with you. You really are a knowledge bank to us, in simple words. Like every time we listen to you and we always come up with something new. Oh, that has added up to our knowledge. Thank you so much, sir. So now I'm starting off with my presentation. So our topic is office etiquettes and behavioral aspects. Manoj sir has discussed a lot about this. And Manoj sir, one more thing. In guru-shishya relationship, you will always be our guru. I am just a student and explaining to other students. So office etiquettes. So have you ever wondered why is it important for us? We CA have already so much of knowledge. Like we outstand from MBAs in terms of knowledge, like balance sheet analysis or anything be it. But why they excel in presentation? Because for two MBA rigorous years, they are being given training only on their presentation skills, their body language, their speaking skills, their attire, dressing sense, everything. Hence, once you step out in the modern world, in the outer world, job world, they always outsmart. Though chartered accountants are much knowledgeable, but if you develop the habit of being in a great personality, having good attire, having good dressing sense, having good communication skills, you will definitely outstand it. So let's take an example. I have covered four topics in my etiquette slides: dressing etiquette, speaking skills, drafting and mailing etiquettes, filing and documentation. So for example, if I am a person, I'm doing job, and I entered into a corporate meeting where I don't know anybody. So how will I attract a person? Another like CFO is standing there. How will I attract that person? It is just by your dressing sense, your body language, your personality. Then only that person will think, yes, he's an appropriate person. Let's go and talk with that person. Second skill comes is your speaking skills. How you will be speaking to him. Hello, sir. How are you? How will you handshake? All these things, as Manoj sir introduced, how to share your visiting card, how to handshake. Those skills are very important to impress a person at first instance. Next come is your knowledge to hold that person. No doubt we have a lot of knowledge. So to hold the person, you have got things. But for the first two things, we will be learning right now how to improve your personality. So talking about dressing etiquettes for men, I would say always prefer a sober dress, sober color shirt, not too colorful, not checkered, not thick straps. Even if you are preferring a checks t-shirt, shirt, please make sure it is a very small checkered, not a highlighting one. Always carry a tie that is not too loud or patterned one. It should go with your dress. It should be soothing and subtle. Accessories, talking about men's accessories, you don't have much to wear, but then you have wristwatch to wear. So generally wear a leather watch, but still if you prefer wearing a metal watch, then don't be some Salman Khan. Itti loose watch doesn't work in professional world. Wear a fitted one, metal watch. Okay, avoid funky bracelets, funky rings. If for men and women both, if you have any tattoos, please make sure you hide it. That doesn't look professional. It is a big no-no for a professional world. Okay, and remember always, we have knowledge. So why to dress? यू माइट बी थिंकिंग वाई टू ड्रेस, वी हैव नॉलेज. मार्क जुकरबर्ग को भी तो देखा है हमने, इतना नॉलेजेबल इंसान है, जीन्स और टी शर्ट में आता है ऑफिस. बट दैट इज हिज प्रोफेशन. इन आर प्रोफेशन अटायर डज मैटर. ओके, सो टॉकिंग अबाउट योर बेल्ट, सो द थंब रूल सेज दैट ऑलवेज मैच योर बेल्ट विथ योर शूज एंड योर बेल्ट बकल शुड ऑलवेज बी अ स्लीक वन. स्पाइडरमैन, सुपरमैन जैसे डोंट कैरी अ हैवी बकल, इट शुड बी अ स्लीक सिंपल एंड सोबर वन. टॉकिंग अबाउट योर शूज, एवरीबडी नोज इट शुड बी क्लीन पॉलिश. सिंस स्कूल वी आर लर्निंग दिस, सो आई डोंट नीड टू शेयर मच ऑन इट. देन कम्स इज योर सॉक्स. लाइक सॉक्स इज अ थिंग दैट इज बींग नोटिस्ड बाय इंटरव्यूअर्स अलॉट बिकॉज दैट शोज एन इंप्रेशन. ऊपर से नीचे तक आप टिप टॉप हो जाओ, विंडो ड्रेसिंग कर लो, बट एक सॉक्स इज द थिंग दैट दे कैन कैच यू. सो ऑलवेज प्रिफर सॉक्स दैट गोज विथ योर पैंट्स. डार्क कलर सॉक्स, ग्रे, ब्लैक, ब्राउन, इट शुड बी. एंड मेक श्योर एंकल लेंथ सॉक्स आर वेरी मच इन ट्रेंड, बट दोज आर नॉट एट ऑल अ फॉर्मल सॉक्स. मेक श्योर योर सॉक्स आर लॉन्ग इनफ सो दैट इट डजंट एक्सपोजेस ऑफ योर स्किन व्हेन यू आर सिटिंग. In interview, when you sit, make sure, in interview or in office, make sure your skin is not exposed because of ankle length socks. The thumb rule says that no white socks. White socks are not acceptable in professional world. Besides that, men should be well-groomed. Like suppose if any person is, suppose you are a chartered accountant now and you are taking interviews. If a person, if an article comes in and asks for interview, then how will you judge first, at first impression? About his body language, his attire, is he well groomed? If he is having a shabby hair, shabby beard, will you select him? You won't be interested in asking any question to him. I believe that. So make sure your hair is short, your shave. Generally, clean shave was a trend, a formal thing. But these days, beards are also accepted. But then neat and clean beard, not a shabby one and not heavy beard. Okay, so September no beard, October no beard, that was a trend. So please September, October mein bilkul aisa mat karna. September, October mein sabse zyada clients aate hain apne office mein. So keep yourself appropriate every day. It is not about ki aap interview ke din you will present yourself as the best and baki ke 3 saal ya in your job life you will be a normal thing. No, present yourself best each day. Then only that attitude, that personality will come out of you. Okay. Men and women, make sure that you, even if you apply perfume or deo, it should not be strong odor. It leaves a bad impression about you to the person sitting next to you. So next is the length of the tie. I have picturized it in my slide. You can observe it. The length of the tie should be just above the buckle. It should not be too short. It should not be too long. And the tie should be properly V, not it V shape. That shows how perfectionist you are. Okay, so make sure, if you don't know, please learn it, YouTube it and learn it, how to tie a proper knot, tie knot V shape. So next come, this is all for men. Next comes is dressing etiquette for women. So there is a lot to discuss about women. So women generally, trousers and shirts are a formal thing, but as per Indian culture, salwar suits are an acceptable thing. So you can carry salwar suit or shorts and trousers to your office. Remember, your salwar suits should be small print, not too gaudy. Your colors should be subtle in choosing your dresses. Dresses should not be a skinny one or a skin tight one. Okay. And a big no to sleeveless salwar kurtis, because why to expose yourself in office? That is not the right place to expose yourself. So a big no to sleeveless dresses. Then comes is your shirt and trousers. They should not be too colorful, not a designer one, simple, sober, black. But standard colors are the colors that are most preferable for your office attire. Next comes is your accessories. So women have very much accessories, generally watch, ring, bracelets, but then remember, everything should not be, all of them should not be funky. Even if you are carrying a necklace, please, it should be a thin liner chain. If you are carrying a ring, it should be small, not a funky one, and not too many rings are a professional thing. Funky piercing is not acceptable. Please avoid it during your professional hours. So about the bag, you generally carry a laptop bag, but then it is recommended that you carry one more bag, professional. It looks professional, your purse. So it should generally be black or brown. The color of the bag should be black or brown. Talking about your heel sandals, so sandals should not be a colorful one, not pencil heel. The ideal size of the heels that is acceptable in professional world is 1.5 inch. So make sure your heels are flat or with heels 1.5 inch, not above that. Remember, for the girls who are having short hair, they can carry open hair, but then for those having long hair, they should make sure to tie your hair. You should look neat, appropriate. Every time you move your hands in the meeting to your hair and your lipsticks and your face, it distracts the other person. So avoid those gestures. That looks very unprofessional. Make sure there is no highlighting makeup, smoky eye or cat eye. That we are not into an acting world to carry all these makeup. Okay. I have already said you avoid strong deos and perfumes. The most important is your nails. It should always be trimmed and neat. Chipped nail paints are a big no-no. Why? Because that looks very unprofessional. Even if you are putting on nail paint, then make sure it is complete. And the color of your nail paint matters a lot, because most of the time you move your hands like this, and on the working papers, everybody is watching your nails. How is it? So make sure it is a subtle color. If you have any tattoo, please make sure to cover it. Here is some slide which says what kind of bracelets you should be wearing, what kind of earrings should be wearing. You should be wearing big danglings are not at all a professional thing, so it is not acceptable. Instead, wear small studs, simple studs. Do not, every day change your earrings with the dresses and wear long danglings. That doesn't work. And one more thing. So as per Indian tradition, you can wear kurtis, right? But then below that, generally plazos are in trend. But then plazos, very loose and broad, are not considered a professional thing. Ghagra nahi pehen ke jana hai apun ko office. Okay. So either you can wear leggings, you can wear jeggings, or you can wear straight fitting pants. Those are professional things. Leggings, maybe it is a common trend that ankle length leggings, capri style leggings, those doesn't look professional because that exposes of your legs. So try and avoid all these things. Next is one more thing for men and women as well. Cotton pants, generally they are semi-formal, considered as semi-formal attires. So it depends upon your office policy. Like I was in KPMG, and for us, Fridays and Saturday, if you are going to the office, you can wear cotton pants, semi-formal dressing. Otherwise, Monday to Thursday, it was strictly formal. So it depends upon your office policy, what they adopt. All right. Next comes is our communication etiquette. So at the in our example, original example, at first instance, we have attracted the person, our CFO. And he comes, because of our dressing sense and our body language, he comes and talks with us. Hello. You will handshake, you know the appropriate style, as Manoj sir explained us how to handshake, how to exchange the card. Now comes communication etiquettes. So how should you speak within office and within with the clients? Manoj sir has explained in detail about how to speak with clients, ask only relevant questions. Make sure you know the designation, the designated person whom you are talking to. Are you talking to the accounts department? Are you talking to the CFO level, or are you talking to the director? So make your language and your questions accordingly. Even over phone, even if you're in office, you receive phone or you call to your clients, make sure you introduce first that, hello, I'm this and speaking from so and so company. Do not directly speak, sir, may I speak to this? Please introduce yourself first and then say, sir, please, may I speak to so and so person, right? So within the office, like how to start your day. The first and the best thing you can communicate is a cheerful greet and a cheerful goodbye, like good night or goodbye. Because even if you're having a bad day, cheerful greeting, good morning and good night, goodbye will all make it normalize. It will settle it down with your principles. Next comes is keep your cell phones on vibration, as Manoj sir already said, and make sure that there are no personal phone calls in your office. Even if you want, you wish to attend those, please move in isolation area or out of the office to talk with them. While talking to others, even your colleagues, do not use slang language. Hey, what's up? No. Even the colleague is and a friend of yours, but then if it is office time, if it is professional time, then do not use slang language. So the next etiquette comes is your email etiquettes. Your email is literally a reflection of you, how you draft your mails. Like suppose you are interviewing a child, that person enters. Okay, you tick mark first thing, his dressing sense, his personality is appropriate. Next thing, what do you do before asking question? Observes his resume, right? What is the language is he using? What is the drafting style, drafting etiquettes, right? You will be observing that whether he knows how to draft a letter, you will be observing that. And based on that, you will create a second impression. Okay, how is he? So drafting an email is very important. So I'll tell you quickly few certain points that you need to remember while drafting email. First is from the mail you are sending. That should be a professional one and not a funky name like coolsiddharth@gmail.com. Please make your email ID is a professional one. caayushmisoni@gmail.com. That looks more professional. Next comes is your subject line. Like your subject line should be very clear, one liner, and it should match with your content. Your subject line goes something different, your subject goes different, that doesn't work. Generally, this happens when loop of emails are being replied over and over again. Phir uske baad, if the child wants to send something else to that person, he attaches in the same email, same chain. Please break that chain because the subject of those loop mails were different and now you are sending something different. So compose a new mail. Okay. Then next comes is like in this example, I have written 2mseats33@gmail.com. So what is it? Suppose this is accounts department, wherein I want to tell that we have to conduct audit for financial year 1920 to Aditya Soni. He is the director of the company. So I'm keeping him in CC because you guys might be knowing the meaning of CC and BCC, and you all must be using it in your office. So I'm repeating again, CC means carbon copy, BCC means blind carbon copy. CC means like if you want to keep someone in loop about the information, what is going on. For example, like I'm sending to accounts department that please make sure you are ready for the audit for next financial year. Get yourself prepared. So I'm keeping his boss director in CC because I want if accounts department does not get our work done, so he's the second responsibility who will be taking off what we want to communicate. I am keeping my senior Atishay Khasgiwala also in CC because he must be aware that what all is going. We have started off this procedure of sending mails to the clients and asking them for the data for the audit so that he stays in loop. Then there are two very important things. Reply all. You be very cautious while hitting reply all. So difference between reply and reply all is reply means you will reply only to the person who is sending the mail, and reply all in which you reply to everybody, to all those persons also who are in CC. So if that mail is not so relevant for your bosses or your seniors to know, then please avoid reply all because it creates unnecessary spam messages in others' mailbox. So avoid that if it is not urgent. Next comes is BCC. So BCC is generally used by us when we are sending a bulk mail, like GST returns ki date aa rahi hai and we want to call for information and inform ki last date aa rahi hai GST 3B ki. So give your information. So we keep all our clients in BCC because we don't want one client to know who is our other client. So blind carbon copy. That means nobody knows whom other email address you are sending to. Okay. So next come is salutation greeting. Make sure it is a professional one. Hey, what's up? No, that doesn't work. Dear sir, respected sir, if he's senior to you, hello, hi, dear team. All these are professional salutations. Next comes is the body of the mail. Language in the body of the mail should be very professional. It should not be a casual one. You are asking for, like in this mail, you are asking for accounts. If you're asking for to get books of accounts ready. So at the end, it looks courteous to write, should you require any clarification or information, please feel free to contact us. It shows the gratitude. Yes, if you want anything, please let us know. We'll clear it off. Next one is the closing remarks. It can be any thanks, regards, best regards, kind regards, yours faithfully. Generally, you use yours faithfully when you don't know the name of the recipient, like when you are using dear sir. But when I'm using dear Mr. Shah Rukh Khan, so I know the person who's receiving the mail, I will write yours sincerely. Okay. Next comes your signature. In signature, it includes CA Ayushmi Khasgiwala, then my designation partner in which firm I am working, Ashok Khasgiwala and Company LLP, then address of my firm and my mobile number. This is how the whole mail is being composed. And always remember one thing, that proofread your mail once you create it. Why? Because aajkal autocorrect itni hone lagi cheez hai ki we write DEAR, uska ho jata hai DEER. So that looks very unprofessional when once the recipient reads it. And one more thing, do not assume that recipient knows what you're talking about. Like, for example, I have been coming across in my practical life that students or people send mail like PFA, BS. I mean, what are they talking about? Write properly in subject, please, a balance sheet for so-and-so company for which year. In mail, write properly. PFA is not a jargon to be used. Write full form. Please find attached the balance sheet for so-and-so company for financial year. For what purpose are you sending? Like, I am sending to director. So I'm sending to the director for his perusal, or I'm sending for his review, or I'm sending his for his finalization, for printing purpose. For what purpose I'm sending? You would say, ki yaar, director ko bhej raha hu, toh matlab it is assumed ki main usi ki balance sheet bhejunga. But no. There may be two reasons. Us director ki do company ho sakti hai. Right. So which company, for which company you are sending balance sheet? Or dusra reason ye ho sakta hai ki in future, when we want to search the mails, these subject lines, these body content helps a lot. Agar aap usme likhoge balance sheet for which year and for which company, that will help improve your search. All right. So moving quickly to the next topic is your envelope etiquette. I don't know why something struck into my mind ki mujhe ye share karna chahiye, because practically I have seen कि कभी कभार people make mistake out of it. So it is very basic. I have written this on my email envelope. So here I have written to the Secretary, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, plot number and then complete mailing address with PIN code. Generally, people avoid writing to the secretary or the person's name whom you are sending to. They generally write Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, Noida, yahan tak pahunch jayega. But kiski desk pe jana chahiye? That is the most appropriate way of addressing the envelope. Kiski desk pe jana chahiye? Secretary, Board of Studies ke secretary ko jana chahiye. So I will write that as well. Then next comes is from whom you are sending. It is to the right corner always. CA Ayushmi Khasgiwala, my company's name, my address, my phone number if returned, then which phone number to contact, which address to return, my email ID. The reason being why I'm not writing from on the left hand side, because it is from here that we tore the envelope. We tear the envelope, right? It is from here we tear the envelope. So if you tear it, your reference to who has sent it will get erased, right? So that is why we make sure that we write from here and in the center whom we are sending to. If it is private and confidential, make sure you write on the top of the envelope, private and confidential. Okay, so moving to our next slide is the last topic, filing documentation and working paper etiquettes. I have made this slide because of my practical experience that you should be knowing. So there are very basic things. I have created a working paper here, sample working paper, Red Chilies Entertainment Private Limited. So I'm on an audit and balance sheet audit. So how am I going to make the working paper? It should contain the name of the company, then for which financial year you're auditing, then ऑडिट वर्किंग पेपर, देन बैलेंस शीट, किसकी मैं क्वेरीज निकाल रही हूँ, एंड इफ इट इज एन इनकम टैक्स पेपर देन मेक श्योर आफ्टर फाइनेंशियल ईयर यू राइट असेसमेंट ईयर बिकॉज दैट इज रेलेवेंट इन इनकम टैक्स. Write the start date of the audit. Write the end date of the audit. It was audited by whom? It was reviewed by your senior or your partner or your principal. Who has reviewed it? Then comes is your particulars. Like you are making out a query for reserves and surplus. You will write particulars, reserves and surplus, issues. May what were the issues that you faced? And status means like whether it is resolved or not. And if it is resolved, how it was resolved? What papers against that we have received? You will write it there. If not, you will write pending. So working paper accurate wohi hota hai ki if you are not in the office and if some third person comes and randomly picks your file and can see everything and understand everything, he don't needs to call you ki yaar isme kya kitna status hai, kya ho gaya, kitna bacha hai isme audit karna. That is the most appropriate working paper that says for itself. So your working paper should be such that ki koi bhi khol ke padhe sabko samajh aa jaye kya status hai. So next comes is your firm's policy to retain and destruct the record. So once you create working paper, make sure you put your working papers flag wise for each item. Indexation is a must. Cross referencing is a must. And it depends on the firm's policy what kind of papers they retain, it what kind of papers they destroy, what kind of they keep. So understand that that from your seniors. Next is the avoid filing repetitive papers in file as well as in the folder in the system. So I have come across people are again and again repetitively filing the same paper above and above. Agar ek student gaya, he audited from a balance sheet, a trial balance se usne kara. Second gaya, usne dusra trial balance ka print liya aur fir wo uske upar hi laga diya. Why to create paper burden for the office? Vaise space is very limited. Mumbai has become short of space and soon Indore will. So avoid creating a paper burden for office as well as in system, like in when you save in soft copies in system, avoid repetitions. Generally kaise karte hai, final balance sheet final one, balance sheet final two, balance sheet final three, matlab the principal who's opening doesn't know kitne final hai, saatwa final hai to main wo kholu ki teesra final hai ki wohi khol dun. So to tackle this, generally avoid repetitions, delete all old versions, but in case if it is so urgent to keep those versions, then make sure you write its name as balance sheet version 1, balance sheet version 2, balance sheet version 3, and only one file should be named as balance sheet final. Generally, in general cases, please avoid creating versions, duplicates of the same file. Next is make sure you save your papers in the correct folder in the system. Generally people have a tendency to create their files on the desktop and at the end of the day they generally keep it there only ki abhi to kaam chal raha hai, jab complete hoga we will save in the right folder. No, tomorrow morning your boss will come, your principal will come and check whether what is the progress of the work, what all you have completed. So once if he doesn't finds it on the right place, then again you will be blamed, where is it? So make sure you save files in the appropriate folder itself. Next is always keep clean your desktops. This is a practice in our office that we randomly check the desktops of each of our staff and delete it so that nobody creates unnecessary burden on the desktop and a mess of folders. That doesn't look professional. Okay. Last and a very basic thing, that once you leave the office, please clean your desk. Whatever filing you are working upon, if it is not complete, still keep it at the right place, right rack, whichever is assigned to it. Keep your working papers in a drawer assigned to you, not a loose one. All right. So this is what my presentation was. I tried to cover like basic things, what necessity things were, and I really hope that you must have understood. Manoj sir ne jo samjhaya, that was a level apart. This was a very basic thing. So you guys must have enjoyed the knowledge, the club of both the knowledge, and enjoy this lockdown period as well as utilize it for your studies, because you are lucky enough to get so much of time to study. So utilize it to the fullest. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for such a great presentation. When you started with mentioning the MBA institutions and their students about how they are training them to give presentation, professional behavior, speaking skills, attire, and other things. Overall, they are only majorly interested in their personality development. So it is a great initiative by ICI that through the webinars, they are enlightening the students and having speakers like you, ma'am. Thank you so much. And you mentioned that, I want to say that people think that dressing perfectly is only for women, but it is equally important for men too. See, socks appear very minimal in our attire, but a tiny thing can lose you everything. So make sure that you make yourself perfect and be the best every day. You also mentioned email etiquettes and envelope etiquettes in this world of WhatsApp and Instagram. Ma'am, I hope these sessions are of great benefit to all the students, members, and anyone watching the webinars. And I thank you personally for being here with us in the webinar. This takes us to the end of the third day of webinar, and I request you all to show their participation in all the activities of SICASA, Indore, and ICI. Thank you so much. Stay connected to SICASA for further information on the webinars. Thank you so much.